Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us here for our regular spotlight lesson. And today we have a really great lesson on reconciliation. But I just want to say thank you to everyone that's joining us live right now. I think Mrs. Murphy might even be joining us if we have any of our third and fourth graders out there that are tuning in here tonight. Just know that Mrs. Murphy is online, and hopefully she will be able to participate a little bit in the chat. But I do want to say thank you to everyone. I know the schedule this year has been a little bit crazy. My personal schedule, traveling and being stuck some places, and that we have not always met on Sunday nights. So I just want to say thank you for everyone for being able to roll with it a little bit and to really, you know, just tune in when we can. So let's get going with our lesson. But I see that we have a good group here. Everyone's kind of signing in. And let's get our lesson started today. Okay, I am now in the lesson. And today we are going to be talking about reconciliation. My name is Michael Fusco. I'm the director of Religious Ed for grades 5 through 10 and confirmation. And I know that Mrs. Murphy, our director of Religious Education for Family Sacrament Group and grades 1 through 4, is here as well. Just, you know, it's always a pleasure to work with her and to collaborate. And really, today's lesson is going to lead us into our big reconciliation session that's going to be coming on up in 2 weeks. Just a couple of, you know, live stream rules. First and foremost, we want you guys to have some fun and, of course, to learn something. The chat room is to be used when we direct you to. You guys can sign in. We can take attendance there. But any other additional conversations, especially when we are talking about something or we're showing a video, we just ask that it is used sparingly. And of course, the chat room is always used for the chat room is always monitored. I see Mrs. Murphy trying to text me on how to log in. So Mrs. Murphy, if you're there and you're listening, you can just log into YouTube with your user account, and then you will have full access to the chat feature, which you might see popping up. And everyone here that's logging in definitely is already logged in. So that's how you use the chat. And if you like this, please like and subscribe to our channel. That's really very important to our numbers. But if there's something that you see or hear tonight that you think is of value to someone else, please share the link so that they can watch and they can learn as well. This is not just restricted to St. Helens people. You can share this with anyone because our content is kind of universal. Obviously, we're talking about Catholic things, but there's a lot of people out there that may really benefit from watching our spotlight lessons and learning and, you know, hearing what we all have to say about things. So let's start our lesson here today with the Hail Mary prayer. So let's start in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. And I'm going to say it, but parents, students, if you're there as well, you can say it with me. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen. All right, so the goals of today's lesson is pretty simple, is to understand what the sacrament of reconciliation is and why we do it, to know that our sins are forgiven. And we're going to run through an examination of conscience to become the best version of ourselves. So a lot of what we're going to do here today is really going to lead us into our last large group session of the year, which is on March 18th and 20th. They will take place in the church. And I know the time, again, is not going to be our normal time, but we are offering this sacrament to all of you. So the time will be, it will start at 6 o'clock, and we have between 5 and 7 priests, I think, that will be available for each session. And once you receive the sacrament, if you choose to do so, and, you know, we're really hoping that after today's lesson, you'll be inspired and, you know, you really will have that desire to receive the sacrament of reconciliation. Once you receive and you kind of spend some time in prayer and penance, then you can leave. So it is really billed from 6 to 8 p.m. But if you go early and you're done, you could be done by 7 o'clock. I don't know what the lines will be. You know, we're trying to have as many priests as available to offer the sacrament to everyone so that the lines are short and that we can, you know, get through this. But today we're really going to learn about what is going to take place, why we do it, and really the benefits of the sacrament of reconciliation. All right, so I've kind of explained that, but it's all here in black and white. Our last session of the year is March 18th and 20th. We're going to have that reconciliation service, and it's going to be offered for grades 3 through 8. I met with Monsignor Tom at the beginning of the year, and this was one of our kind of combined goals. We really want to be able to offer this to you guys because, you know what, let's just face it, most of us don't go on a regular basis, and I'm going to include myself in that. I'm really busy, and sometimes I just don't go. So when I'm in a position where they're offering it, it's really nice to be able to go. So we really felt, having that conversation, that this is a good opportunity for everyone to learn more about the sacrament and then to have the opportunity to experience that sacrament. The session will be from 6 to 8 p.m., We're going to arrive. We're going to have that opening prayer. Monsignor Tom will review the sacrament. We're going to have an examination of conscience, and then you will have the opportunity to receive the grace of the sacrament. Once you've done so, you are free to go. Parents, take advantage of this. You know, this is not just for our students. The sacrament is for everyone. And, you know, us adults, we make mistakes, we fall short sometimes, and it's really great that you can go and you can do this with your child. So I really encourage you to be here, be with us, and to actually receive the graces the sacrament provides. So let's rewind and see, what is the sacrament of reconciliation? The sacrament of reconciliation is one of the most unique and beautiful aspects of Catholicism. Jesus Christ, in his abundant love and mercy, established the sacrament of confession so that we as sinners can obtain forgiveness for our sins and reconcile with God in the church. The sacrament washes us clean and renews us in Christ. This is a really beautiful sacrament that, you know, I think is underrated. People always think, oh, why do I have to tell my sins? You know, I'm embarrassed by those things, or, you know, it's bad enough to kind of dwell on them. Now I got to talk about them. This is really a beautiful way for us to be reconciled with God. All right, so here's some trivia words and some, you know, really important Catholic words. The first one, culpability, big word, the responsibility a person has for acts, thoughts, and omissions. For an act to be sinful, the sinner must, one, be aware that what he or she is doing is wrong, and here's the most important thing, is that we freely choose to do it. So if I know it's wrong to make fun of other people, but I know it's like, you know what, I just can't stand that person and I'm going to let them have it. I've chosen to act in a way that is not good. So that's the word culpability. Mortal sin, an action so contrary to the will of God that it results in a complete separation from Him and His grace. It must involve grave matter. The person must have full knowledge of the evil act and give full consent in committing the act. Mortal sin is big time stuff, like murder. Now, most of us don't fall in that category, but you know, it is an important word that we should know. A venial sin, and this is most of what we're going to experience, especially when we are going to a confession, is that most of our sins are venial. It's a less serious offense against the will of God that diminishes one's personal character and weakens but does not rupture one's relationship with God. So maybe we lied about something. Maybe we gossiped about something. Maybe we're just looking at something on our phones that's inappropriate. You know, those are venial sins that we choose to do, but they're not really, it is not of grave matter. All right, so I have a short video here. Let me see if I can get this up. You know what? We're going to skip this video because I have a better video. All right. So I don't know if any of you have ever watched the movie The Witch, The Wardrobe. But it is really an amazing scene when Aslan the lion goes and, you know, talks to one of the boys about the things that he's done. And it's really a very good scene to show the demonstration of what confession is all about. So I'm going to play this little clip from The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. And you're going to see how amazing this scene of reconciliation is. And if you know the story, you're going to be, you know, really kind of surprised that this is a beautiful moment of reconciliation.
What's done is done. There is no need to speak to Edmund about what has passed.
And Edmund, try not to wander off.
So, I know it's a short little clip, and the volume might have been a little bit low, but in that scene, Edmund had been out, and he kind of like betrayed his family, and he went off with the White Witch. And this is a scene where he kind of comes back, and he knows he did things wrong. And Aslan the Lion, who is the Christ figure in the movie, really has that, you know, one-on-one reconciliation time. And then he just tells everyone, what's done is done. It's in the past. It's forgotten. His sins have been forgiven. That is exactly what the sacrament of reconciliation is like. We all fall short. And to know that we can go and have our sins forgiven, and what's done is done. We can't dwell on them. We can't go back in time. And it is something that is just truly beautiful. Let's go back into the lesson here. All right, so I have a scripture reading, and I want you just to read it with me. Close your eyes and try to think about what this passage is saying to you, and then read it again. And then ask yourself how you can respond to this. We're going to have a short discussion about the scripture passage, but you can also have a short discussion with someone who is with you right now, maybe a family member, or when this live stream is over, you can talk about it. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." That comes from the Gospel of John 20, verse 21 through 23. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. It's a really important piece of scripture. So just think about these words and how it applies to reconciliation to yourself. All right, so here's some questions. And this is the time where we can use the chat. So let's look at some of these questions. When was the last time you went to confession? So if you know that you went maybe last week, you could type it in. If the last time that you went was in second grade, you could put that in there. If you don't want to answer that question, you don't need to. So put that in the chat. You can also answer the question, why is it so hard for us to confess our sins? Let's start with those two questions and see what answers we get. All right, so when I had to do my communion, so for some of you guys, the last time you went was when you were like in second grade. All right, so I'm going to put this up here. It feels embarrassing, Devin. I understand that very much. And, you know, I went to confession maybe 2 weeks ago. Mrs. Murphy and I were on a retreat ourselves, and they offered reconciliation. And, you know, I was sitting there in the pew. They had the Blessed Sacrament out. nice, beautiful music. And people start to get up and go to the confessionals. And I'm kind of looking over and saying to myself, all right, you need to go. You need to go. But I still sat there for a couple of minutes. And it took a little bit of psyching myself up. But I have to say that once I got in there, it was awesome. I got to talk about, you know, the things that I struggle with. And look, we all struggle with things. And the priest was really great. He gave me some advice. He prayed with me. And then he absolved my sins. I left there feeling really, really good. But, you know, sometimes we're not so proud of the things that we do. So let's see what we've got here. It's so hard because we sometimes don't want to admit bad things that we have done. I agree, but that's what this sacrament is about. And it's about us talking about that. And there, this is like no judgment zone. It's not like the priest is going, you're bad. No, it's just the opposite. That they're saying, okay, well, let's try not to do that again. And let's ask God to forgive our sins. See, it could be scary to tell someone, even though it's a priest, and it could be private to you. Joey, totally understand that. And a lot of our sins, sometimes are sins against ourselves. Things that we do that we don't like. You know, if we're mean to someone, you know, it's hard to say, yeah, I was that person that was mean. Yep, I was the person that didn't do this, or I just watched this. So it's really, really hard. And I have a short video for Monsignor Tom, and he's gonna talk to us about that. But it is something that is really good. All right, so it could be hard because you may think that they would judge you and maybe they wouldn't forgive you at all. And I'm here to tell you that is not true. The priest is not there to judge you. They're operating in persona Christi as in the person of Christ. So just think, you might be looking at Monsignor Tom, but he's really acting in the person of Jesus. So when they're doing that, that is called in persona Christi, that they are there to administer the sacrament and to give you God's blessing and forgiveness. Really great responses. I'm very impressed. All right, so let's take a look at the next two questions. Why do we need to wash away our sins? And what can we do to avoid sin in our lives? What do we need to do to wash away our sins? And what can we do to avoid sin in our lives? Think about these two questions. All right, so Lily, it says, since you might not know the priest, it could be hard to share your sins. Well, the good news is that when we have this service, Monsignor Tom will be there. And you may know some of the other priests because they're all pretty local and they do a lot of other things here at St. Helens to help us out. Let's see. We can avoid fights and trouble with other people. All right, That's really good. When we start to avoid conflict with other people, that helps us sin less. All right, we need to wash away the sin so we can forgive ourselves. Exactly. And that's exactly why Jesus gives us this beautiful sacrament, so that we can forgive ourselves. Sometimes we do a terrible job at forgiving us. We might be able to say, like, I forgive you as a friend, I forgive my mom and dad for whatever, but when it comes down to forgiving ourselves, that's pretty hard sometimes. So Jesus gives us this beautiful sacrament so that we can go in and we can say our sins and then be given forgiveness. We can walk out of there knowing that we're clean, that those sins have been forgiven. Now, the key piece of this is to try to sin no more, or to repeat that. You know, a lot of times we repeat, you know, sinners, that we kind of fall into like doing one or two things all the time, and it's kind of hard to overcome that. But if we keep this in mind and we keep working at that and telling ourselves to be the best version of ourselves, we can start to sin less or sin no more. We're always going to make mistakes, and that's why we have this beautiful sacrament. Jane, very good. We need to wash away our sins because in order to forgive ourselves and stop feeling guilty about what we did, you can go to reconciliation. And that is exactly why we're trying to do this service coming on up. Monsignor Tom and I really felt that it was important. And, you know, I think it's something really good. Let's go back to these questions. All right, so let's look at the last two questions. How can you forgive others in your life more? And do you know that you're forgiven and loved by God? Sometimes we kind of doubt that. Am I really forgiven? Does God really love me? And the answer to those two questions are yes, you are forgiven. And yes, God loves you so much. How can you forgive others in your life more? I think that's an important question. How can you forgive others in your life more? Sometimes people do things to us and we really don't like it. And we kind of want to get them back. You know what? I don't like that. I'm going to get you. That's not what Jesus wants. Jesus wants us to forgive others, to pray for them. And for those people that hurt us or do wrong to us, for us to be able to pray and to learn to forgive. If more people forgave more people on a regular daily basis, that'd be really great. I can't tell you how many times I'm out driving in my car and someone's honking on their horn, or, you know, they yell at you, you know, because you didn't make that turn, you know, fast enough, or, you know, the light was yellow and you didn't cut through it. And now they're honking their horn and they're you could see them in your rear view mirror. They're yelling at you. That's kind of crazy sometimes. If we would forgive people more often and let those things be bygones, I think we'd be in a happier world. Let's see some of your answers. We can forgive others when we see them, but it's hard because you don't want to admit what you have done sometimes. All right, that's a really good answer. You can forgive others in your life by telling them, "I forgive you." Those are super powerful words, more powerful than you'll ever know sometimes. But when you can say to someone, it's okay, I forgive you. Wow, a lot of things in your life can change and change for the good. We can forgive by not doing back and remembering that everyone makes mistakes. Absolutely, we all fall short. We all make mistakes. Let's see. Here's a great answer. We can forgive others by talking it out. Parents, you can talk it out with your kids, with your coworkers, and sometimes with other family members. I know that, you know, Easter, we're about the halfway point, and you might be preparing for the big holiday. You might be traveling, or you might be hosting. And any time that we have extended family around, sometimes there's a lot of conflict that, you know, who didn't do what, who did this, who said that. It can be very stressful. So let all of us during this time of Lent really try to forgive others, but more importantly, articulate that. Say it. Hey, I am sorry. I'm sorry I said those things. I'm sorry I posted those things. I'm sorry for X. It's not easy, but that is really great. And, you know, parents, we're, you know, we have complicated lives ourselves. So all of this stuff applies to you as well. All right. So what I'm going to do right now, before I get into this examination of conscience, I have a great video made a few years ago with Monsignor Tom, and he's going to explain step by step what goes on in a typical confession. So as we prepare for this class, let's watch this video and hear it straight from our pastor, Monsignor Tom, about receiving the sacrament of reconciliation.
Hello, I'm Father Tom, your pastor, and I'm very happy to be able to walk with you through what a typical confession in the Sacrament of Reconciliation would be like. I know you're already familiar with this space that we use for the Sacrament of Reconciliation, and this is exactly what you would see when you come into the room. You do have the choice that you can either kneel before the screen over on my right behind that you saw earlier, or you could come face to face sitting right across from me. Now, I know it can be difficult sometimes to go to confession. I often find it difficult to go to confession. We never find it easy to confess our sins to another person, and that can make it very, very challenging and sometimes can make us reluctant to make use of the sacrament of reconciliation. But whenever you feel that way, just tell yourself that this sacrament is one that is about God's forgiveness, about God's unconditional love for you, and his desire for you to be able to be forgiven for the times that you have failed to be the person that you need to be or that he calls you to be or to do what he asks you to do. Sometimes we also get worried a little bit about the formula, the form that we used, and we can be concerned because we say, I don't know what I have to do. Never worry about that. Never worry about the form. The priest will help you to walk through the process and walk through each confession as I'm doing with you right now. So never be afraid that because you don't know the form that the priest will not guide you through. We will. We'll walk through it with you. When you sit down, we start, as we start all forms of prayer and all sacraments, with the sign of the cross, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And typically what you would do as the one confessing your sins is you would say something like, bless me, Father, for I have sinned. It's been so much time since my last confession, and these are my sins. But if you don't say that, you can be prompted by the priest who, after greeting you, could say to you something like, may the Lord be in your heart and your lips that you make a good confession. And then you would confess your sins to God. While the priest is sitting here and hearing your confession, keep in mind that the priest is really an instrument of God. An instrument of God's forgiveness, an instrument of God's grace. It's really God to whom you're confessing your sins, and God who is really coming to you in this sacrament. So at that point, then, you would confess your sins. Before you come to confession, as was probably covered with you, you could do what is called an examination of conscience, in which you really give some thought, give some prayer, and reflect about the times that you have done something wrong, or that you've hurt somebody, or that you haven't done something that a Christian or a disciple would do. Then you would confess those sins, just as frankly and as honestly as you can. You tell the priest your sins, really realizing that you're telling God your sins, and the priest will listen. The priest will listen to what you confess and allow you to thoroughly confess the sins that you want to put before God, and place before God for his forgiveness. After you confess your sins, after maybe a sigh of relief, after being able to speak them out loud, which is a very, very important part of the sacrament, to be able to take your sinfulness and put it outside yourself, the priest may give you some words of consolation, some words of encouragement. He will remind you of the breadth and the depth of God's forgiveness, of how much God loves you and how much God really, really wants you to know the peace and to know the forgiveness of your sins. He will talk about God's forgiveness, how God forgives you for your sins. That's what this sacrament's all about. It's not so much about the sins as much as it is about God's forgiveness, God's mercy, God's compassion, God's love for you as his child, and his desire for you to be that best version of yourself. And so I'll give you some words of encouragement, assure you that your sins are forgiven you, but I'll also talk to you a little bit about God's grace that comes through this sacrament. Grace is something that God gives us. You might call it strength. You might call it his inspiration, but it's a reality that allows us to become the better people. So not only do you get the forgiveness of God in the sacrament, but you also get the grace of God in the sacrament, the grace that will allow you and strengthen you to do better, to try harder, and to be the best that you can be.
So hopefully that was a good insight to what the sacrament of reconciliation is all about. You heard that? I've talked about it, but you heard that from our pastor. And what I really like about that is that when Monsignor Tom says, you're going to be talking to the priest, but it's really God that you're confessing the sins to, not the priest. You're really confessing your sins to God. So good. And I really encourage everyone that's on here, everyone in grades 3 through 8, to really take advantage of this opportunity. Most of you have expressed that it's been a long time. Even when I went, and I went about 2 weeks ago, it was a long time since I went. And, sometimes I can convince myself that, I'm too busy. I'm always running the program and blah, blah, blah. I just didn't go. That's the bottom line. And when I had that opportunity at the retreat that Mrs. Murphy and I went to through the catechetical office, and they had 4 or 5 priests there, I took the time to go, and it was really beautiful, and I felt great after. So I really encourage all of you to take advantage of that. What we're going to do right now is that we're going to run through an examination of conscience, and it's the same one that we're going to do when we meet, so that you're comfortable, you've already heard it before, and it helps us think about things that we should be confessing, maybe we haven't thought about. So it helps us to evaluate the things that we should or should not be doing. So we're going to do that next, and then we're going to pretty much wrap up our lesson. So here is the examination of conscience. You don't have to worry about the chat. This is all personal. When we go to confession at our next large group, we're going to review this. Think about all of these questions, and they can help you in your confession. Do I love God above all things? Is he number one in my life? Or do I put myself before God? Have money and pleasure become more important to me than the God who created me for himself? Have I ever used God's name out of anger, that is, as a curse word? Have I deliberately missed Holy Mass on the Sabbath, Saturday evening through Sunday? Do I disobey my parents? Do I fail to respect my parents? Have I hurt anyone's reputation by deliberately spreading rumors or keeping rumors alive by passing them on? Do I have anger against anyone? Do I hold a grudge? Have I ever freely and deliberately entertained impure thoughts? Am I modest in my dress? Do I steal from my friends? Have I ever stolen from a stranger? Am I a liar? Am I guilty of slander, that is, spreading lies about someone else? Do I gossip about others? Am I jealous of others or what people have? Do I harbor unforgiveness and grudges against others? Am I a resentful person? Do I put others down? You guys can go and look at those slides again. And when we meet for our final large group, that will be the, you know, examination of conscience leading us into that confession. So maybe you heard something there that you thought about. Yeah, I've done that. Then when you go in and you have that reconciliation, you can confess that to God, and it's really kind of on the tip of your tongue. It's not like you have to prepare for this or psych yourself up. Just be truthful. Speak from your heart and, you know, really just tell God all the things that you're sorry about. And then ask for his help. Ask for his blessing. Ask God to help you overcome those things. That's one of my prayers a lot. Is that when I struggle with something, I ask God to help me with that. And it really helps. It helps me, you know, every single day. It's really an important part of my daily prayer that I ask God to forgive me for the things that I've done, but ask for his help on the things that I struggle with most. So what we're going to do is that we're just going to wrap up our lesson here with an act of contrition. This is going to be a prayer that we're going to say before we give you the opportunity to go to reconciliation. So it's kind of like done together in a group. But this is a prayer that you can pray anytime, especially if you feel like you've really kind of made a mistake and you really want to say a prayer that's focused on reconciliation. So let's say this prayer together. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Oh my God, I am heartily sorry for having offended you. And I detest all my sins because of your just punishments, but most of all because they offend you, my God, who are all good and deserving of all my love. I firmly intend, with your help, to sin no more and to avoid whatever leads me to sin. I know there's a lot of different versions of the act of contrition. You can Google it, and maybe you print it out. Maybe you have it right there. And, you know, if you don't know how to say this, what I did, I'm going to admit this, is that when I went to confession, I quickly pulled up the act of contrition and had it on my phone. So at the end of my confession, I just read the act of contrition, and that works. So you could definitely do that. And I'm sure the priest might have like a little prayer card for you to say. And then he may say something like, you know, go and say a Hail Mary prayer and spend 5 minutes in prayer afterwards as kind of like penance. So that's really what the whole service is about. And we're really excited to have you experience this. We're doing this lesson here today to prepare you for that, so you're just not coming in and you have no idea what's going on. That we really want to prepare your heart and your mind for this sacrament. And then when we go together, we're going to review this again. We're going to have some quiet time, and then you'll be able to go to receive the graces that this sacrament offers. All right, so I do have a couple of announcements. So once again, this is our big last large group session, but that Sunday before, which is St. Patrick's Day, it's a big day, we're going to have a combined youth day with our high school kids and you in middle school. So everyone is going to go to the 10 o'clock Mass. I know we normally go to 12 o'clock, but we're going to go to the 10 o'clock Mass, and all the kids are going to sit like in the section over by the media booth. And at 11 o'clock, we're going to have a combined youth day. We're going to have green bagels, green juice, games. All of our peer ministers are going to be there along with the high school kids. It's going to be a really fun day, and everyone grades 5 through 8 are invited to come. So you're going to get a special email telling you about this. It is Sunday the 17th. It's actually St. Patrick's Day. And that is a combined youth day, 10 o'clock Mass. And if you don't go to Mass, you can still come. So it's 11 to about 12:30. All sorts of St. Patrick's Day themes, green bagels, juice, all that kind of stuff. Lots of food, lots of snacks, lots of games. And it's a real nice mixer between our high school kids and the middle school. Don't miss that day. And then the very next day, we have our reconciliation service on Monday and Wednesday. And that pretty much wraps us up for the year. But that leads us into Palm Sunday and Holy Week. You don't want to miss all the great things that we do at St. Helens to prepare us for Easter. And, you know, that's really a beautiful time. Easter's really early this year. So Easter's in March, not even in April. So, you know, it comes up really fast, but I really encourage all of you guys to come to Youth Day. And then, you know, we have our big last large groups, and that leads us into Palm Sunday. And our youth group does an amazing job on Palm Sunday, recreating Jesus' passion. And that will be at all the Masses. So make sure that you come to Mass on Palm Sunday. And that leads us right into Holy Week, Good Friday services. I know that Mrs. Murphy and I always run a Living Stations of the Cross outside. So we have all the crosses that are in the back parking lot. We have different, you know, readings and reflections for that. And that's open to, you know, anyone, parents, kids, anyone from grades 1 through 10 can come and experience the Stations of the Cross outside. If it's, you know, pouring rain like it's been like the last couple of days, that gets moved inside. Still very effective, but know that if it's a beautiful day, and hopefully it will be, that we can have the Stations of the Cross on Good Friday. And I believe that is like 12 o'clock. I'm not positive on that, but we will be sending out information about all the Holy Week stuff. That wraps up our lesson here today. And, you know, Mrs. Murphy's husband is chiming in here. He says 12 noon, Good Friday, Stations of the Cross, March 29th. Don't miss it. And I'm going to put this up into the broadcast. All right. Good job. So it's good to see Mrs. Murphy on there. 12 noon, Good Friday, Stations of the Cross. We have St. Patrick's Day, Joint Youth Group, Large Group Reconciliation Services. Lots going on this month. And we're so glad to see you and to minister to you and help you become the best version of yourself. That's it for us here today. Thank you so much for joining us. Pass this on to someone that might need to hear and learn about the Sacrament of Reconciliation. And we'll see you at all the events that we've got going on here at St. Helens. Thanks a lot. And we'll see you later.